Let's wait for the recording to start. I think it's taking a bit of time. Okay. Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all for the online class on signals and systems. And let us start with the concept of convolution in this online class. So I have convolution integral. Convolution integral. So very important concept here. I have this convolution integral where we are going to use integration. So most of the mathematical operator here, what I use is integration. So that is the name why it is given as convolution integral. I have like integration operation which is to be performed on such signals. Now here we are going to consider, if I want to integrate the system, I would be taking x of t as an input. So it is a continuous time signal. It is a continuous time signal. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, and definitely y of t is also a continuous time signal, and x of t and y of t is said to be input and output signal. Input and output signal. Now if I consider this input and output signal, I have the signal which can be modeled as x of t as an input, and I have this one which is y of t. So x of t as an input and y of t as an output. So if I want to recall this, I'll be having the t operator where y of t is given by the t operator of x of t. So y of t is given as the t operator of x of t. So if you could recall the discrete time system, I have y of n equals x of n convoluted with h of n. So if you could recall, it can be written as this for a discrete time signal. Okay. Now by the equation which is there for a discrete time signal, I have k equals minus infinity to plus infinity x of k and delta of n minus k. So this delta of n minus k can be written as sigma k equals minus infinity to plus infinity x of k into h of n minus k. So this h of n minus k is the shifted version of the input signal that is applied as delta of n minus k. So which is the impulse response of the system. This is the impulse response of the system, shifted version, impulse response of the shifted version, what I can call here. So I want to make an analogy with respect to the input signal. That is like, if I want to have both x of t and h of t that is to be applied, I can have by analogy for a continuous time system, for a continuous time system, and the given input as x of t with input, I can write x of t as integral. I have integral. So that is, I take a new variable, that is minus infinity, tau being the like the other variable. I have x of tau delta of t minus tau, which is there, which is d tau. Okay, so I have y of t being t operator, that is x of t like this. So which is y of t equals t operator x of t. Got it? So next, what I have here is, y of t equals t operator, that is there. So this is x of t, integral tau being minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau, okay, x of tau delta of t minus tau d tau, t minus tau d tau, that is that. So I can apply the t operator on this system. So if I have this input signal, there is where I can take it as a common factor, and I can write it as equals integral t tau, which is minus infinity to plus infinity. I have x of tau t operator that is applied on delta of t minus tau, which is there. Okay, that is d tau. So this operator, what I'm writing here, this operator entirely is called as the impulse operator, or we can call it as impulse response of a system. Okay, so I can write it as h of t equals t operator delta of t, t operator delta of t. So what I can do now is h of t minus tau, that would be equal to t operator delta of t minus tau, which is there here. Okay, so it is a time invariant operation. So the system under consideration is said to be time invariant, and a suitable shift in the input will also have a suitable shift in the output. If you could recall the system, you will be having it called as a suitable shift in the input will change the suitable will have a suitable shift in the output also. Got it? So I can write y of t, I can write this equation can be written as y of t equals integral tau, which is minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. Okay, t minus tau d tau. So I have y of t equals x of t convoluted with h of t there. Okay, so next, what do I have here? Y of t equals integral tau equals minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. Okay, so this is what I generally call it as CI, which means convolution integral. I call it as convolution integral. So the fundamental result is what we are going to get. So I can have y of t equals x of t convoluted with h of t. I can write this as integral tau equals minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. Okay, so y of t equals these things there. Okay, so I have this convolution of two continuous time signal. So what I mean by two continuous time signal is this one, which is two continuous time signals. I have convolution operation that has been applied. So convolution operation been applied. So I have this one as the convolution integral, which is to be applied, and I have h of t being the impulse response of the system. So remember this equation what I have written here. So I'll write it again. Y of t equals integral tau equals minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. This is one thing there. Okay, so moving on to the properties, it's quite simple. All the properties, that is starting with commutative, associative property, and also the distributive property holds good. Okay, so I'll not going to do the detailed explanation of it when it comes to properties. I'm just going to say it as properties of convolution holds good for continuous time signals, for continuous time signals, continuous time signals, which is first one commutative, second one which is associative, and the third one which is distributive. Okay, so I got these, which is commutative, associative, and also the distributive properties, which holds good for a convolution integral. Okay, so I have this terms here. Okay, so I have this commutative, associative, and distributive property, which holds good. Okay, so I have certain identities also, what you can remember. Identities, it is a standard identities. What is that? I have x of t convoluted with delta of t. So that would be equal to x of t alone. Okay, so x of t alone. So if I want to prove it quickly, I'll write it here. I'll be having integral tau equals minus infinity to plus infinity. I have x of tau, this one being the time shifted there. I have delta of a t minus tau, a d tau. Okay, so it would be equal to x of t. This one would be equal to x of t. So what is a delta of t minus a tau? Its value would be equal to 1 when t equals tau. Okay, so and its value will be equal to 0 elsewhere. Okay, so this is a impulse function what we have got. This is an impulse function what we have got, and we can write it as x of tau. Okay, x of tau, the value which is there. So I'll be having t is equal to tau. That is where I can write it as x of t there. That is where I can write it as x of t. So I have this first property which is to be verified, which is x of t convoluted with delta of t, that would be equal to x of t. So this is one more standard identity that you can keep in your mind. Okay, so next one, I have the shifted version, which is that is x of t is there, the input signal, and I have the impulse signal where it is time shifted by t naught. Okay, so what is the output here? I mean, what it would result as? It would result as x of t minus t naught. And the second identity, I'll show it here. I'll have x of t convoluted with a unit step function, that is u of t, that would be equal to integral minus infinity to t x of tau d tau, x of tau d tau. Okay, so let's start here with this one, which is integral. Let me show you the integral tau, which is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, that is x of tau. Okay, x of tau, that is there, and you will be having delta of a t minus tau, which is that. So this is considered to be delta of t minus t naught. So this t minus t naught is there along with minus tau. Okay, so along with minus tau, so this is considered here as t minus t naught and along with minus tau. Okay, d tau. Okay, so I have x of tau, which is that, that would be equal to tau, which will be equal to t minus t naught. Okay, so where I have t minus t naught, that would be equal to tau, I mean the value which is there, so it will be equal to 1. Okay, so I have x of t minus t naught, which I can write it easily. Got it? So next one, I have x of t and convoluted with u of t. So integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau u of t minus tau d tau. Okay, so I will be having u of t minus tau, which is there. So that value would be equal to 1, and the next value, which would be equal to 0. T minus tau will be greater than 0. Next, I have t greater than tau, or tau would be less than t. Okay, so I can also write it as 0 for t, for tau greater than t. Okay, so I'll be having integral starting from minus infinity to t. Okay, so I need a value which is equal to 1. So the tau value would be from minus infinity to t. That is where it will be having a unit value, that is its magnitude would be equal to 1, and I can write x of tau d tau as the output. So this is the output where you have got it. Okay, so these are simple identities what you can keep in mind. And next one, we have convolution integral operation. So what are the steps that we need to keep in mind? What are the steps that we need to keep in mind to have this convolution integral operation? So we know that a y of t, that would be equal to x of t convoluted with h of t, that would be equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. That is that we have x of tau h of t minus tau d tau, which is there. Now I can apply the commutative property. I can also write it as y of t equals h of t convoluted with x of t. So that can be written as integral minus infinity to plus infinity. I can have h of t. I can have the shift here for the input signal t minus tau d tau. Okay, so this is where you will be having this function, so which is quite easier to evaluate. So when it comes to this one, okay, so you will be having the convolution integral. In some cases we will use equation 1, and preferably 90 to 95% of the times in the numerical problems we will be considering this equation here. Okay, so what you need to do while following the steps for a general thing here. So I have y of t that would be equal to x of t convoluted with h of t, which is that I can write it as integral minus infinity to plus infinity, that is x of tau h of t minus tau, which is the d tau. Okay, so this is the thing what you will be doing, and you can apply the commutative property also to this convolution. So step one, I will be having the impulse response. I'll be writing it as impulse response h of tau, which is there. Okay, so it needs to be reversed, and then shifted by t to form h of t minus tau, h of t minus tau. Next, second step here, what you need to remember, you have a signal x of tau, which is there, x of tau, and h of t minus tau, which is there, are multiplied together. Okay, we are performing the multiplication operation, are multiplied together for all values of tau with t fixed at some value. At some value. So this is the second step. This is the second step that is got. So and we got step three, which is that what you need to do, the product x of tau and h of t minus tau is integrated all over tau to produce an output y of t. Next, step four. Okay, so again all the three steps are repeated, all the three steps are repeated as t varies over minus infinity to plus infinity to produce entire output y of t. Okay, so these are the steps which are there for convolution integral operation. So let's move ahead with a single problem in this class, and later we can have few more problems which are to be solved, and we can certainly find out how do we go with the steps for the convolution integral operation. Okay, convolute two signals, two continuous time signals. I'll be a bit more precise here. Continuous time signals, that is x1 of t equals e power minus 2t u of t, and x2 of t equals u of t plus 2. Now it is quite easy for me to have this convolution operation that has been applied. I have y of t equals x1 of t convoluted with x2 of t. Okay, so I will be having the unit step function where I can generally change it quite easily to the time shifted version of it. So I'll be having integral tau, which will be from minus infinity to plus infinity x1 of tau, and I'll be having x2 of t minus tau d tau. Okay, so I have this functions here, and I'll be integrating again over minus infinity to plus infinity, considering the fact that tau is already there and I have x1 of tau. So once when I have x1 of tau, e power minus 2 tau, which is there, and u of tau. Okay, so next I'll be having x2 of t minus tau. So this is where I'll be having replacing t with t minus tau. So where u of t minus tau plus 2. So this t value is being changed as t minus tau plus 2. So u of tau is there, which is the first signal, and this is where I'll be having the second signal, x1 of t, and I mean tau here, sorry, x2 of t minus tau, which is there. So I have the overall output as y of t. Okay, got it. So I have reframed it with the new variable, that is tau. Okay, so next one I'll be having it as two different cases. So just before writing the two different cases, I will be able to sketch the signal depending on it. So I will be having the signal which is to be sketched, which is x1 of t. So I'll write it here, x1 of t is e power minus 2t u of t. So I'll be sketching this signal, or I can write it as x1 of tau, that is e power minus 2 tau u of tau here. Okay, so I will write this as the tau variable, and this one is also a tau variable, and I will be having this one which is being written like this, which is 0 here. The 0 value will have a unit magnitude, and u of 1, that is that, that is also 1, e power minus 2, somewhere around here you will be having the value which is e power minus 2. Okay, so this is x1 of tau, x1 of tau. So next, how I can write this one, which is x2 of a t minus tau. What it has been written here is u of t minus tau plus 2. How I can write this u of which is that, which is t plus 2 minus tau also I can write it. So the new variable is where I should write it as the t plus 2, the t plus 2 parameter which is there. So this can be taken as t generally if I want to take it. So this is considered as t minus tau. So it is a shifted version, a shifted version. How I can write this? I'll be having it shifted with the parameter which is t plus 2, and this is the tau axis, and this is x2 of t minus tau, x2 of t minus tau, and its magnitude is said to be unity, and its magnitude is said to be unity. So I will be having two cases here. I'll be having two cases where this is a right-handed signal, this is a right-handed signal. So the first case is where I will be having to evaluate the output of a system that is having for t plus 2 less than 0. Okay, so less than a 0, or I'll be having t less than minus 2. T less than minus 2. I'll be having x1 of tau and x2 of t minus tau. Okay, x2 of t minus tau, which will have no overlapping. Okay, so which will have no overlapping, and y of t will be zero. I have y1 of t that would be equal to 0. This is the first output. Now if you see here, this is the right-handed signal, and this is where you will be having a shift of like say t plus 2. So it gets a value which is from 0 up to the left hand side. It is having a no value there, right? So it is said to be 0. So it starts from, if I say 0 here, I don't have any value which is there. So it starts from t plus 2. Now there is no overlap here. Considering the figures here, I don't have any overlap in the system or two signals. That is the reason why I can certainly say it as the output of a system, the output, that is, let me say the output, which is said to be equal to 0 for this region, which is t less than minus 2. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Let's move on to the next one, which is case 2, which is case 2. So if I have case 2 here, I should be having t plus 2 greater than 0. T plus 2 greater than 0. I'll be having, or I can write it as t greater than minus 2. Okay. So there will be an overlap. There will be an overlap of signal. x1 of tau and x2 of t minus tau. Okay, so once I consider this, I consider the first one as a t plus 2 less than 0. Next, I consider t to be greater than minus 2. Got it? So there will be an overlap of the signal x1 of tau and x2 of t minus tau, which will be overlapping. Okay, so there is an overlap of the signal, that is x1 of tau and x2 of t minus tau. So how I would be able to evaluate this output is from integral minus 2, okay, so which is there as Okay, so I can write this as, yeah, 1 minute. Okay, 1 minute, 1 minute. Okay, so it'll be having, just not to confuse, I'll be taking it as t plus 2 greater than 0 there. So what I'll be doing here is, this value, I'll keep it as the upper limit and it starts from 0. So instead of having, like, what did I do earlier just before that? I'll be having minus 2 to t, right? So if I add plus 2 on both the sides, it would be resulting in integral 0 to t plus 2 again. Okay, so that is what I wanted to mean here. But if you take it from 0 to t plus 2, that is where it is starting from the case 2 here, right? So I'll be having this t greater than minus 2. So minus 2 to t, if I take, that is also right. Or if I add the limits, so I'm evaluating over the limits and I will be getting the value which is there as 1, that is the unit step per signals that is there, and I'll be having e power minus 2 tau, e power minus 2 tau d tau, okay, e power minus 2 tau d tau. So what I'll be doing here is, I will be having e power minus 2 tau divided by minus 2, that is there. So it would be from 0 to t plus 2. So I'll be having minus 0.5, which is the e power minus 2 t plus 2, which is the minus e power 0. Okay, so I'll be evaluating here. I'll be having the functions, which is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 e power minus 2 times t plus 2. 2 times t plus 2. I have taken a common factor and I have retained it as an output. So this is also an output of the signal, that is y2 of t. So I have two outputs here. I have two outputs, which is y of t. So one having y1 of t, which will be equal to 0, and y2 of t, that would be equal to half, minus half e power minus 2 t plus 2. Okay, so what is the values, what are the values that are there here? I have the values, which is for t less than minus 2 and t greater than minus 2. So I have these two values which are there. Okay, so what you can generally have here is, you have two values which are there, and you need to have the evaluation based on the limits that has been set up here. Okay. So what I want you to do is, I have one more thing here, what I can give you now. The same thing, I want you to convolute these two signals, e power minus 2 tau u of t. And I have x2 of t, which is given as u of. So it was a t plus 2 here. I'll just change it as t minus 2. Okay. So convolute these signals and obtain the output at y of 2, and obtain the output y of 2, or determine the output at y of 2. So what is the output at y of 2? Okay, so you have to give t is equal to 2, and let us find out what is y of 2. Okay, and what is y of minus 2? So after inferring these two results, you have to compare y of 2 and y of minus 2, whether both the values that you get, the output at the positive value and also the negative value, is it same? So you have to compare, and you have to let me know that whether both the values are same. Okay, so meanwhile, let me stop it here.